Welcome back, one and all. My name is Altamar, and we are going to be continuing our Let's Play of Icewind Dale. Where we left off last time, we were in the caves, where this former red wizard turned bizarre ogre thing is standing.
Fine by me.
And we're going to go take a look around. He said that somebody has cursed him. And we're going to find out how to help him a little bit. I mean, we're not usually in the business of helping evil red wizards, but there are worse things to do, like helping the Zentarum. There's some Ettins. There's a corpsicle with some loot. With some loot that we're full on. Do I do this? Nope. Where's the bag of holding? Oh, it's on my freaking warrior. Right. Okay. No big deal. Alright, back in the shadows. Nothing else down this way, but just three Ettins.
Ready. Agreed.
We should probably go come kill them off, you two. You can pretty much handle that on your own. Hey, how's it going, guys? Now, stop hitting me. That hurt quite a bit. Still, we are laying waste to them, really.
I'm listening.
Any loot? No, of course not.
Ready.
Why would we want loot from our giant monsters that we killed? That's silly. Loot is for the weak, apparently. Alright, quick saved. Rested. Don't get out of the shadows just yet. We need you to do more scouting. Possibly down this way. But definitely while you're hiding, because doing otherwise is silly. And will most likely end in her untimely death. There's some Neo-Orogs. New Orgs. As opposed to the old ones. And this leads to more Neo-Orogs. Quite a big troop of them, even. And that's where we found that body, which had a book. We should probably read that book. What does the book say? Kalibak's journal. I'm afraid I may have been duped. Bandoth indicated where I might find the door to the forge, but I was unable to find any trace of it. I was prepared to search later in the evening, but a group of Ettins have encamped in the passage north of where I am now, and I am in no condition to be running past them. Hopefully, I will get another opportunity to search the old meeting hall of the dwarves. Earlier, I uncovered some writings regarding a room within these walls that leads to the lower segments of this complex, and I can only assume that this room lies behind the door I have yet to find. To make matters worse, the same writings infer that this room contained a puzzle that was designed to keep invaders from discovering and desecrating the cemetery and forge. Perhaps Bandoth can provide some more assistance. Unlikely. Alright, let's go kill some orgs. You.
Understood.
We could probably just fireball them, actually. Just weaken them off a tiny bit. Get rid of that. Keep that. You're going to be our scout. Spotter for our fireball sniper. It's really his official title now. Alright. Now you three go forward. Because I'm sure they're not going to be thrilled about that. Or they might not come anywhere at all. Maybe they've just decided that this is their life now. Regardless, let's see what happens. Some of them are dead. Go clear out the rest. Our archers just finishing them off one after another. That was gruesome. Anything useful? No. Just some experience. We really didn't have to kill them. They weren't really in our way. But we did. Because experience. Experience is very important to our leveling endeavors. Unfortunately, we are... Well, our archer's almost leveled up. Everyone else is sort of really not close.
Orders. Got it.
We should have made our ranger a elf, actually, but no. Oh, shit.
I'm listening.
I'll make this as painless as
possible. All right, we're doing this live. Not that it's particularly hard, I guess.
Ready.
Bet they can't even hit her. She's got negative 10 armor class or something like that. It's pretty huge. That was absolutely a waste of arrows, but that's okay. We could have saved our arrows and used fireballs if we had done that better. This place we might fireball, because I think this is a camp that has lots of enemies. Krillag is here, but he wants to talk. That Avenger does not want to talk, however, and neither do the Marauders. Is that it? Just that? That's four of them? That's it? Oh, never mind. There's five. There's at least one more back there. I saw him. You can't hide back there, you know. I can see you. There's another Avenger hidden over there.
Quarters.
Okie dokie.
All right.
Let's quick save. Of course. And we're gonna move forward. Who are you? What do you do here? I am looking for the Orog Chieftain. You have found him. What do you want? Well, I've come to obtain your badge. You will get nothing, and you will die. I really beg to differ about that one. Whoop.
May I help?
You may help. I require a Cloud Kill spell. Right there. And then I require... not that. I require... a fireball right there. Not there.
Surely.
Right there. Nope. There we go. That's fine. You can bring
Help me, I best,
sir. How are you doing?
I am ready.
Make sure he doesn't reach my wizard, please.
What is your will?
And yes. You, good sir, get another one of those going. Man, none of the other guys are coming. Okay. Way in through. Don't walk into the cloud kill. That's a terrible idea. Ooh. Anybody else coming through the cloud kill? Alright. Suit yourselves. Nobody's left alive.
Ready.
Right then. Now we just have to wait for the cloud kill to wear off. If only we had a zone of sweet air spell.
How may I best, sir?
Zone of fresh air? Something like that. Maybe it's zone of sweet air. I think it's a cleric spell. We can actually just look. Nope. That's true seeing. Can't see level 6 spells. Can't remember what it even looked like, to be honest. That one? That's righteous magic. That's mass cure light wounds. Nice. Counter commands. Greater command. Level 3 spell? Exaltation. Oh, there it is. Zone of Sweet Air. We don't have it memorized.
Here.
What we could do...
I'm on it.
...is sort of glitch the game a little bit. Well, not glitch the game, but we'll just... out of sight, out of mind, right? Oh. Sorry. It would appear that we've encountered a few friends while we were sleeping, and now we must kill them in the most gruesome of ways, and hopefully our rogue won't die. And then we'll take another rest. More experience, though, so win-win. Thank you.
Yes, I'll
now,
take care of it.
Let's go see who is left down here alive. There is a sword. Oh, right. Right. Where's that stupid bag?
Orders.
Get
understood.
Up here. I require you to be not the bag holder, because our rogue should be the bag holder. So what is that? Oh, right. It's the Golem Killing Hammer. Heavy crossbow plus 2? Would be nice if she could actually use it. I don't think that rogues can use heavy crossbows. Not 100% on that, though. You. Grab that, that, that. And that. How much experience did we just get for that? Oh, 70,000 experience. Nice.
Fine by me.
Anybody else still alive down here?
I'm
a marauder. All right. Come finish these off so I can loot their bodies, see if there's any loot in the room. There's a sword at least. How are these guys not getting hit by fireballs? That's my question. Any other loot? Note? Nope. That's unfortunate. Can I ID the sword? Of course not. Why would I be able to do that? What's this do? It's just the badge. Alright, we have Krillig's bags. Or badge. Bags. We have his bags. We have his badge. And we got some priest spells on our ranger. I forgot about that. So he gets a few as he levels up. He gets one level 1 spell and one level 2 spell. They are ranger spells, so they're technically druidic spells. He has Flame Blade, but he's so worthless with swords that it won't matter. Barkskin's nice. No alignment is not very good for us. Good berries are pretty much worthless. Or are they? 5 points of healing. They're pretty much useless. Okay, find traps. We'll just give him healing. Maybe instead of healing here, we will give him... Not that. What was that do? No, not that. A shalala. It's a shillelagh, actually. Shillelagh. Something like that. We'll give him the spell that we never use on our cleric, so there we go. Actually, why? Why would I give him a spell like that? He's never ever going to cast Bless. Just give him Cure Light Wounds so he can help us heal up when we were sleeping. That's pretty much it for this tunnel. Let's go talk to this dude. Get rid of that. Alright. Greetings again, traveler. I have disposed of the Orog Chieftain and acquired his badge. I am forever in your debt to you. I cannot speak. Oh, right, my Shatner. I am forever in your debt. I cannot speak much longer. I must tell you that each of the 6 have such a badge. Should you go in search of him, you will need to obtain each of them. I must rest. Goodbye. Now we need to find the way out of here because I can't remember where it goes. Maybe down this way? We'll find the way out. I can't remember exactly where it is. It also might be up that way. Let's try this way first. It would appear not. That is just a dead end. Let's check down here. This might also be a dead end, but we can take a look. It's not looking good for a not dead end. Alright, not there either. It said it was a secret door, didn't it? Maybe the secret is that it's hidden.
As you wish.
We'll take a quick look around. Maybe it's hidden in this encampment too. If it's not here, then we'll have to worry because it might be. No, that's just that one little alcove area. I know it's not in the Great Forge area. Or is it? It might be.
Done.
You know what? Let's go back. We can always take a look around. Doesn't hurt anybody. If it is a secret door, I'll come back for it. Wait, what did the journal say? It said something about that. Alright, well, we'll continue on. And we're gonna go down here.
Understood.
Or, sorry, in there, I guess I should say. To the Great Forge. Which is where we were before, we just didn't explore it. We came to do the caverns first. Over in the cemetery area. Almost everybody's there. Good, excellent. And we're going down. Traps are not reset, which is always a positive. Don't want to blow up.
Got it.
Okay, Great Forge. So this is the Great Forge, obviously. It looks very Great Forge. Well, this is the first part of the Great Forge, I should say. This is the actual Great Forge itself.
Ready.
All right. We're going to quick save. And then we're going to go up here. You suddenly feel very, very cold. Defiler! Have you too come to desecrate the remains of our home? No, not really. Then why do you disturb this temple of Moradin? I was hoping to learn more of the conflict that occurred within this area. Two catastrophes within Dorne's Deep. The first was the destruction of our community at the hands of the orcs. More recently, there has been the occupation of our cemetery, the Tears of the Dead, by the necromancer Terrakhan. Terrakhan? Terrakhan is a wretched necromancer that came to Dorne shortly after the strife that put an end to our community. He was aware of the tragedy that gripped Dorne's Deep and knew it would serve as fertile ground to continue his research. What was he researching? During the construction of the Deep, we had the misfortune of uncovering a cavern that housed an ancient vortice from the negative energy plane. Now, I don't know if some being from that plane felt our presence, or if the vortice itself was disturbed by the intrusion, but shortly thereafter, undead began to appear. And these undead invaded Dorne's Deep? At first, it was merely a skeleton or two, nothing we couldn't handle, but over time, we received more and more reports of undead sightings. In the end, I don't think any of us were prepared for what would become known as the Battle of the Dead. And how did the battle begin? One morning, our community awoke to the screams of the son of Jamoth. He had been playing with within some of the caves near the forge, and claimed he had seen a group of skeletons. We sent a few men down to investigate. They returned badly wounded. What had they found? Hundreds of skeletons, zombies, ghouls, and other undead had suddenly appeared in the Vortice Cave, preparing to attack the settlement. With time working against us, we assembled our remaining soldiers and went forth to vanquish the deceased. But hundreds of undead with even greater numbers to follow, the dwarves would have surely been outnumbered. No Dorne's dwarf would concede defeat while our community was threatened. Our wounded began to accumulate, and many of our brethren joined their attackers in spiritual unrest that day. Just as it appeared we might have to retreat, a miracle occurred. Go on. From within the tides of flesh and bone emerged Jamoth, hacking at the dead around him with a fevered glee, bellowing with laughter. With each swing of his weapon, the undead around him disintegrated, regardless of whether he struck them or not. It was a beautiful sight to see, my friend. So the undead fell around him just by his presence? How is that possible? Jamoth and our community were touched by Moradin that day. We later discovered the vortice that had brought forth the undead was somehow reversed, returning the spirits to their home within the plane of negative energy. Then Terrakhan came. As a necromancer, he must have heard about the vortice, correct? Yes, once our community no longer inhabited these chambers, Terrakhan took up residence in the Hall of Heroes, with a determination to restore the vortice. He is convinced that if he unlocks its secrets, he will be able to manipulate other vortices throughout Faerun. How? It seems the energies of the vortice would kill any man that approached it. Terrakhan knew no mortal man could ever master the vortice. Shortly after his arrival in our home, he began preparing himself for the rituals necessary to become a lich. Fortunately, Terrakhan must have neglected some of the proper enchantments, as the powers he wields are inferior to much of his kind. If so, can you stop him? He is much more powerful than I. I am fortunate to continue to inhabit these chambers with my own mind. Once Terrakhan learns of any dead within these halls, he seeks to destroy their will with his necromantic arts. Anything that lives, he slays. I could destroy him for you. That would not be an easy task. You cannot destroy Terrakhan by striking him down. It's his life force that sustains him, not his shell. Life force? Liches store their life forces within specially constructed phylacteries. Most liches go to great lengths to protect their phylacteries, often placing them in remote locations where none can find them, then safeguarding them with enchantments. Terrakhan, however, feels his phylactery is safest close to him, and he has placed it within a crypt in the Hall of Heroes. So all we have to do is get there and destroy it? The phylactery is not something that can be destroyed by common means. To destroy it, you need to remove it from this plane. A daunting task, to be certain. No less daunting than the other impossibilities we've been forced to endure in coming north. That's not true at all. How can we remove this phylactery from this plane? That's where fortune favors us. The very vortice that Terrakhan is studying can destroy him as well. It lies within the Hall of Heroes, inside the Tomb of Jamoth. Any undead being, regardless of power, is pulled back to that dreadful plane of existence upon entry into the tomb. That is why I've never been able to enter the tomb myself. So, let me get this straight. I would need to take the phylactery inside Jamoth's tomb to destroy Terrakhan. That's not too hard. But to reach the Hall of Heroes, you need to pass through the Tears of the Dead, where Terrakhan resides. Not only that, but the great door to the Hall of Heroes is locked, and I'm certain Terrakhan possesses the key. If you defeat Terrakhan's physical form, make haste for the Hall of Heroes, for he will only be subdued a short while. I'll see what I can do about that. Let me ask you other things. Tell me more about this conflict that occurred here. Two catastrophes. Oh, we already did that. Tell me about the destruction of your community. Throughout the history of Dorne, we've always had to contend with the orc hordes that threatened our very way of life. However, thanks to inspired diplomacy between the leaders of our community and the elves of the Severed Hand, we forged an alliance that kept both of our homes safe from harm. And what happened? Corruption from within led to a falling out between our people. No longer organized into an effective cohesive whole, it was only a matter of time before the orcs overran both settlements. What caused the corruption? I'm not certain, but it was apparent, at least from our perspective, that someone was deliberately trying to seed mistrust between the dwarves and elves. When the orcs began appearing in appearing far better equipped than previous, the elves began to suspect that dwarf smithies were in league with the Horde. Why would they think you'd supply your enemies with weapons? The elves felt we could not control our appetite for gold, so we were accused of providing the orcs with superior armament. Later, the elves took their accusations a step further and accused us of arming the orcs with the intention of having them destroy the severed hand. Who was providing the orcs? Not any dwarf within Dorne's Deep, I can tell you that much. We were warriors, not betrayers. If truth be told, I believe both communities were deceived by someone within one of their own families. I know not who, but I hope when that person meets their end, they feel the pain of every dwarf and elf that lost their lives. Gotta go. I should go. We're gonna take a look around. Not gonna defile anything. And we have to go into one of these tunnels, and I can't remember which one we're going to. Let's go closer and see if we can figure out which one's which. It should show us on our map, but it doesn't, so let's just go into one. I don't care. Ooh, that's a lot of ghouls.
Yes. No trouble at all.
You got this. Go.
Orders.
You need to taste this.
Now the lich is going to be up there. I don't know if he has true sight. I honestly cannot remember, but we can't loot these bodies just yet. We will eventually. We're going to quick save and go up there and just take a look to see if he can actually see us. Yes, there's a lich up there somewhere. There he is. Oh, he's casting true sight. Oh, no, he just cast shielding. Interesting. No true sight. Well, that's cool.
I'm listening.
Kill that dude. Is that the lich? It's a Juju zombie. At least it's not the lich yet.
I should slay you.
Oh, there's more zombies to take care of, too.
I will assist you in
shoot that guy.
Gladly.
Oops.
May I help?
Shoot that guy.
Ready.
Is that the lich? No, another Juju zombie.
Are you ready for me?
I'm gonna officially rename those to Jube Jube zombies. Because Jube Jubes are awesome. Actually, they're not. I just remembered how much I hate Jube Jubes. I think they taste like garbage, personally. So, I'm gonna rename them back to Juju zombies because that's better. I think they're Juju, actually, but that's okay. Now. Since the lich isn't breathing down our necks at the moment, we're just going to kind of take a... That's an armored skeleton. Don't care about that. I'm going to take that shield.
Orders.
Kill that dude.
Right.
One single hit. We'll take care of that. That's another armored skeleton. Which is probably just one solid hit away from dying. What's this? Reinforced large shield plus +2. Pretty decent. What's that? I don't know. What's that? I don't know. What's this? Surprisingly, I don't know. It looks like a dagger plus +1, but I guess it's not. Perhaps it's a dagger plus +2.
I'll take care of it.
Oh.
How may I best
come shoot this thing for me. I'll I need to go see if there's more tombs to loot. What's that? That's a white.
Ready.
You want me?
Pull back a teensy bit so that we have a little bit of room to maneuver without going up to face the actual lich. Why did you fail at hiding in shadows? What's that? Oh, ghast. Okay. Priest, get back to you.
I will do so.
Here.
You know what we could have done, actually? Is probably use Turn Undead to kill all those ghouls. They weren't very hard. And her Turn Undead abilities probably could have just exploded them.
I'm listening.
But that's okay.
Of course.
Oh man, that's a lot of things up there.
Yes, I will do as you ask.
Right. Take care of that as well, please. Actually,
I am ready as always.
You just stand right there.
What's up?
And turn on dead. I'm pretty sure you'll be able to kill something.
Sure.
I am ready.
Yes.
Okay.
I'll take care.
Back in the shadows, get up here. It totally works. Cool. Alright.
Quickly now.
Undead will come at us indefinitely until we deal with this, but I just want to see if there's anything worth looting up here. Usually only the trapped ones are worth looting. Although this one's the exception. It's kind of garbage. Somewhat better. Just looting away the Hall of Heroes. Or not the Hall of Heroes, the Tears of the Dead or whatever. Oh.
What's up? Here they are! Fine by me.
Indefinite amounts of undead are coming, by the way. Oh shit, that hurt. You're okay. That hurt. Okay, no more moving. Short sword. Alright. I don't think anything else is worth looting in here, so we're not gonna take the stupid bolt. Screw that. It's not worth it. Ooh, that was close. Alright, we're gonna eventually have to go upstairs and beat down that stupid thing. But we're gonna jump back into the other room for 2 seconds.
Yes.
Ready.
You want a taste of this?
Got it.
We're just gonna quickly have a rest.
Agreed.
Go back in. Alright. So we're going to face off against this lich now.
Done.
At least briefly. Because we can't kill it technically at the moment. Okay, you're gonna go fight that.
Ready.
You can kill that. You. Take that down, and then I'll take a second for you. That was bad. Oh, those are greater mummies. That's bad news. Okay, you cast. Where's your dispel magic? That's there. Kill that thing. Kill that thing too. That hurt. Everybody else, shoot him. That's unfortunate. All right, let's reload.
Ready.
Okay, so there's 2 greater mummies there as well, which is a little bit unfortunate.
Yes. Right up.
Okay.
Yes. Neighbor calls me.
Ready. Sure.
Get rid of that first.
I am ready.
What's up?
What? I am off.
Yes.
Cool.
Sure.
Made it just in time.
Here.
Go beat him.
I'm listening. I'll get right
on there. Why are you not visible? Go hide there somewhere.
Orders?
Yes. Your desire.
I am ready.
You have my undivided attention.
Are you ready for me?
What is your will?
Okay, we have to be kind of careful how we do this.
Quick, I am off.
We're gonna shoot the greater mummies.
Yes.
Try and keep them from. Right, they can't be hit by my character. But they took the brunt of that damage, so I'm perfectly okay with that, actually.
Ready.
You want me?
Oh, you're way at the back. This is so annoying.
I am ready.
I'm listening.
Get rid of that.
What is your will?
Ready.
You get up the stairs. Okay, that guy's dead. That one's almost dead.
Tell me I
orders.
Your desire.
It searches. Vita
Mortis.
He still has a shield spell on, which is a little bit unfortunate.
I'm listening.
Slow. Ugh.
You have my undivided.
Turn undead.
I'm here.
Vita Mortis Care.
Alright, everybody gets in on this.
It is a shame that we must resort to violence.
Come with me.
Whatever he just cast is annoying, but not terrible. We're not going to loot anything. We're just going to kill him and then go.
Got it.
Right, we need the key. Where would the key be? Probably in one of these.
What's up? Sure.
We have a brief period of time. Nope. Yes, good. Alright, moving on.
Done.
Moving upstairs.
Vita Mortis Care.
The Lich is still not quite ready to die yet. He's right here. You shoot that thing. Okay, so now we have some graves to do, and we're actually out of time. So we're gonna do that in the next video. Like always, if you have any suggestions or comments, please leave them below. Otherwise, I'll see you in the next one. We're gonna do another couple tonight, at least, hopefully, and then I'm gonna go play some Overwatch. It's gonna be sweet. Also, as a reminder, I'm gonna remind you guys every video until next Friday. Drunk Theft Auto is coming up on this Friday. It's going to be good times, it's going to be live streamed, and I will be there to have a chat with you guys. If you guys have any questions, or you want to just, you know, talk while I die horribly while racing high-speed vehicles, that's cool too. So, I will be reminding you of that every video from now until next Friday, so just a heads up. Take care, guys, and I will see you next time.